Genie Mini 2 is a versatile photo and video creating tool. In this tutorial, we'll be showing you how to create both single and multi-row panoramas. Let's start with a single row panorama. To begin, mount your Genie Mini 2 on a tripod, making sure it's level. Mount your camera and plug in the shutter release cable. Turn on the Genie and connect using the Genie 2 app. Tap Panorama under Quick Setup to begin. First, we'll set the size of the camera's sensor. If you're unsure of your camera's sensor size, it can be easily found on Google. As we're using the Sony A7, we'll set it to full frame. Aspect ratio will generally be set to 3:2, as this is usually the case when shooting stills. But if you are shooting in a different aspect ratio, then change it here. For focal length, set this to the length of your lens. If you are using a zoom lens, make sure you set it to the focal length you currently have the lens set to. We'll set it to 35mm. Under orientation, set this to landscape. If you have your camera mounted in portrait, then you can change it in the app here. Once you're done, tap OK. Now we'll set the start point using the on-screen joystick. Move the joystick left or right to frame up the beginning of your panorama. Then tap start. Next, use the joystick to set where you want your panorama to end. Then tap end. Once you're finished, tap done. Ensure your capture time is set to longer than the shutter speed of your camera. This refers to how long the Genie Mini 2 will wait for your camera to shoot before moving on to the next frame. If you're shooting at night or in low light, you may need to increase this to allow enough time for the camera to shoot and save the image onto the card. You can also adjust overlap of each image. We recommend setting it to 40% to give you plenty of room to align the images together later. Now you're good to go. Press the Rec button to start capturing your panorama. You can then take these images and stitch them into a panorama using software such as Lightroom or Photoshop. Now, we'll set up a multi-row panorama. Using two Genie Mini 2s and a pan tilt bracket, you can shoot much larger, more expansive gigapixel images, and even 360 panoramas. For this, mount a Genie Mini 2 on a tripod and attach the base of the pan tilt bracket. Be sure to line up the three lines on the bracket with the three icons on the Genie Mini. Attach the second Genie Mini and the arm of the pan tilt bracket, again lining up the markings. Next, mount your camera and connect the shutter release cable. Then turn on both the Genie Minis and using the Genie Mini app, connect. Like the regular panorama, we'll set our sensor size, ratio, and focal length. Then tap OK. Now we'll use the on-screen joystick to set the bottom left corner of our panorama. When you're happy, tap start. Then move the joystick to where we want the top right of the panorama to be. Tap OK to confirm. If you decide things aren't quite framed up right, it's fast to reframe your panorama. Just select any corner and tap to reframe with the joystick. You may find that all the frames don't fit on the screen if you're using a phone or older device. Don't worry, just scroll across to see them. If you need to shift the whole image a little, you can select the center frame and adjust it to move the whole panorama evenly. If you're shooting at night or in low light, you may have to delve into the advanced settings. You can increase the move shoot delay to give the camera some extra time to shoot and save the image to the card. You can also change the start position if you have an object that may move during the panorama, such as a person. Now you're ready to shoot a multi-row panorama. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to the Syrp YouTube channel for more tutorials, quick tips, and feature guides.